Good morning dear students, welcome back to your English class. Today we will discuss chapter number 5, a musical instrument. Dear students, imagine you have to make a musical instrument. What would that instrument be and what kind of sound will it have? Let's move on to a brief introduction of the poem Musical Instrument, which is written by Elizabeth Barrett Browning. The poet described the decimation of river bed and crafting of the god Pan's famous flute. God Pan is the main character of the poem. From the name itself, clear the Pan is some great personality having a head of a man and lower body part of a god. He is considered as a god who fell in love with a wood nymph Syrinx. But Syrinx turned into reed in order to save herself from him. Great God Pan cut down 7 pieces of reed and fashioned them into the flute. This poem beautifully showcases how Pan destructs the reeds to find Syrinx and creates a flute. We can say also art is beautiful, but at the same time it can be destructive. Let's understand the poem. What was he doing, the great God Pan, down in the reeds by the river, spreading ruin and scattering ban, splashing and paddling with the hoof of a god, and breaking the golden lilies afloat with the dragonfly on the river? First of all, we will understand the meaning of some words. Pan, that means a half god, part man and part god. Reed, these are tall plants. Scattering means disperse or break down the things. Paddling, to move in water that is not very deep. And hoof is a horny part of a foot in animals. Let's understand the meaning. What was he doing, the great god Pan, down in the reeds by the river? In these lines, the poet begins with a question. He talks about the great god Pan. The Pan is known as a god of hunting and resting, music and shepherds. Pan goes down by the river in the reeds, spreading ruin and scattering ban, splashing, padding with the hoof of a god. Pan is creating a scene of destruction here. So he was ruining and scattering everything in the shallow water with his hands or legs. Breaking the golden lilies afloat with the dragonfly on the river. He was breaking the golden lilies which were floating on the river and harmed the dragonfly which were resting on those lilies. Understand the stanza number 2. He tore out a reed and the great god Pan. From the deep cool bed of the river, the limpid water turbidly ran, and the broken lilies a dying lay, and the dragonfly had fled away. Here he brought it out of the river. Look on word meanings. Reed, tall plant. Limpid water, that means clear water. Turbidly, that means muddy. Ere, that means before. And fled, that means to run away. See the explanation. He tore out a reed, the great god Pan, from the deep cool bed of the river. In these lines, the poet tells an image of decay and death in search of the reed that he wants. The Pan tears a single reed out of the river bed in search of Syrinx. With water turbidly ran and the broken lilies a dying lay. As he tears the reed from the river, the clear water turns into the muddy water. And beautiful lilies now lay down and dying. And the dragonfly had fled away ere he brought it out of the river. Meaning of these last two lines, that is, the dragonfly flees from the river when the Pan pulls the reed out from the river. Because Pan is destroying the lilies and scaring of the dragonflies, he cut the reef and that water, a clear water of the river, is turned into muddy water. And here the poet witnessed that Pan is disrupting a piece of ecosystem. All these things were happened in the violent way.